The word unprecedented has been used a lot in the past few weeks. Today it took on a new meaning with the federal government declaring war on the bushfire crisis. The contribution of the Defence Force has now turned into a full-scale military response. The only question, why did it take so long?
Readying for battle in a war of a very different kind, HMAS Adelaide being loaded with supplies to join other ships already involved in one of the worst fire crises the country has seen. Under pressure for days, today from the Prime Minister, action.
Today's decision puts more boots on the ground, puts more planes in the sky, puts more ships at sea, and puts more trucks to roll into to support affected communities.
That means the compulsory call-out of 3,000 Defence Force Reserve personnel to be deployed in fire-affected communities. HMAS Adelaide, the Navy's largest amphibious ship, will join in the evacuation of isolated communities. Three extra Chinook helicopters from Townsville will now join the effort, along with a C-17 Globemaster, a C-130 Hercules and three C-27 Spartans. Defence Force bases from Brisbane to Adelaide will provide temporary accommodation for those with nowhere else to go. An extra $20 million will go to leasing four more large water bombing aircraft. The decision to call out the reserves in particular, not taken lightly.
It is the first time that reserves have been called out in this way in living memory, and in fact, I believe, for the first time in our nation's history.
The Adelaide will be off Australia's southeast coast by tomorrow afternoon. It's fully equipped for disaster relief and humanitarian aid. It can operate all of the ADF's helicopters. It has 400 crew, including medical staff on board, along with 300 tonnes of much-needed emergency supplies.
Its commander says it's a role they're well used to in our region. This is the same, but different.
Aid to our own people, to our own countrymen, it's a very significant task, and it's one which, of course, we're incredibly proud to be able to respond to.
Among those on board, able seaman Kelly Curry from Nowra, where she has family and friends.
Basically, I'm honoured as well to go down and help out the people in the communities in my area, not just in my area.
The Prime Minister has been adamant in recent days that the government was responding, was doing all it was asked to by the states. That changed today, 24 hours after a PR disaster.
To ensure that we're giving everything that is needed on the ground without being asked.
Perhaps stung by the widespread criticism, an ad campaign was ready to go. Not everyone's buying it. On social media, a common question: why has it taken the PM so long to step up? The opposition leader reluctant to pile on.
My concern isn't for Scott Morrison. My concern is for those people whose lives are in danger today.
At least this afternoon, help is on the way. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.